William Fargo. William George Fargo, born in 1818, died in 1881, was an American businessman who pioneered in long-distance express service. He was born in Pompey, New York, on May 20, 1818. He left school at 13. After several unsuccessful business ventures, he became agent at Buffalo, New York, for Pompery & Co., forwarders from Albany, New York, West. In 1844, Fargo became a partner in a new firm, Wells & Co., which carried its operations west as far as Chicago by the late 1840s. After several consolidations in 1850s and later, the business emerged in 1868 as the American Merchants Union Express Co., with Fargo as president. In 1873, the firm became the American Express Company. Meanwhile, Fargo and others had embarked in 1852 on the more ambitious venture of a transcontinental express service from New York to San Francisco. The new firm, Wells Fargo & Co., competed with Adams & Co., but upon the failure of the latter in 1855, Wells Fargo gained almost a complete monopoly of the field. Cargo was carried at first in hired stagecoaches, which later gave way to company coaches protected by armed guards. Not only did the firm carry mail and supplies to the miners, but it also brought their gold dust. An outgrowth of this frontier banking is the present Wells Fargo National Bank in San Francisco. An energetic and resourceful man, Fargo amassed a large fortune. In Buffalo, he planned and built a $500,000 mansion equipped with $10,000 worth of crystal chandeliers. He was mayor of Buffalo from 1862 to 1866 and was a director of several railroads and other corporations. He died in Buffalo on August 3, 1881.